Hey everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Andrew, currently a gap year student entrepreneur in Malaysia. And on this channel, we'll explore ways to improve our work, our life, and ourselves in general. Today, we'll be talking about how to get started on things. Before we enter today's topic, I'm actually starting out new as well, because this is actually my first video after my channel restart. So here's some history of my YouTube channel. So I actually started out YouTube in 2012 when I was uploading like fun and gaming content onto my YouTube channel, and I uploaded all the way until 2017 when, you know, new responsibilities come in and then priority change, so it became dormant. So I actually only used it to submit some competition video submissions. But yes, this time I actually decided to start up YouTube again because I find that it's actually a very good way to diversify your identity. Second, it gives me more opportunity to learn stuff, especially in video recording, video editing. And third, it may be a source of passive income because it's quite important to build a digital asset right now. So this may be something we'll talk in the future. But yes, now that I've started, let's explore why you should get started. There are basically three main reasons why you should get started. The first one being, if you never started, you're basically failed by default. So, okay, many people have this fear of failure when they start, when they think about starting out things. But if you actually don't take this opportunity to start it, you won't succeed as well. So, in which case, you've basically failed. Second, it's a very, very good way to diversify your identity. Just like me starting out on YouTube. When you start out something new, you actually add a new element onto your life. And this experience, whether succeed or fail, it will be a good story to build your identity. And having a good story to tell, isn't that good? Isn't that interesting? Yes. Third, you actually get more opportunity in life when you get started on things. So a lot of people actually say that there's not enough opportunity for them to showcase their talent. But opportunities have always been there, just that have you actually go and grab onto the opportunity? So opportunity is actually like a domino effect. Like when you push the first brick, all the other bricks will fall and leads to the end where everything falls off. So basically, you can kind of depict the brick as an opportunity. As you started on one, more will actually come in. And as you accept more and more that which you actually want to do, you end up with some opportunity which can fully showcase your talent. So go ahead and start on whatever opportunity that you see now. Hopefully by now you are actually convinced to get started. So I'll give you the real hard truth here. Getting started is the hardest part, because I actually say that getting started is equivalent to a rocket liftoff, hence the name of this video. A rocket is actually actually built of around 80% of rocket fuel and just 5% of the payload. Why? Because when a rocket tries to exit Earth orbit, it takes a lot of rocket fuel just to go against Earth gravity and go to the International Space Station. However, all will be worth it when they deliver the 5% of payload to the International Space Station. Because, well, you know that how many people get to work in International Space Station? How many people get to experiment in space? Basically, it's a scientific marvel being able to do that. So all those effort worth, effort basically become worth it after this. Just like me starting out YouTube this time, it actually surprisingly takes me a lot of effort as well, because I have to relearn how to record video, editing video. Because one thing is that I kind of forgot how I did it, and second is that my previous knowledge isn't as good, so I learned that there's better ways to make better videos. And of course, I have to set up a new video planning system, because I don't want to just like oh shit, I gotta make content this week. Let's start churning out a script. So I have a system where we can just have ideas there. So every time when I want to make a video, I just pick one up. So yes, it takes a lot of effort, but the thing is, after you have gone through all this effort into starting a thing, it becomes easier after that. Because when you getting started is like actually building a machine. It's very hard. First, you have to build it piece by piece to make it into a fully working machine. But after you get it done, it's very easy because you just use a manual and you follow the step-by-step guide to actually operate it. And it gets easier after that because it becomes a habit, you know how to use it. Like now, scrolling through your phone is never as hard, right? But for our grandparents and stuff, if they never used all this before, it may be something hard for them. That's why getting started is hard, but think of the reward. At least for me, starting out YouTube, and the my end destination is actually to diversify my identity, to learn more stuff, and possibly build a passive income. All those rewards are actually worth the effort that I'm doing now. So why not? Let's get started. Well, since I've told you that getting started is hard, then some people might start to have fear. And this is actually a common enemy for everyone. Maybe not everyone, but most of the people. So, fear. Like what I said just now, many people fear failure, that's why they don't start out at all. But basically that means you fail. But some people have other fears as well. Like example, they fear how people will see them after they start out on something. Or they fear that they don't have enough knowledge to, like example me, I might be afraid that, oh shit, I don't have enough knowledge to start a YouTube channel. Should I do it? And third, this is quite common where people just are afraid of how their life will turn out. Like, maybe it's a life course which I don't want to go into. Should I actually start it? But think of it this way. So, starting is actually important for you since, like my last step, you thought about the reward, so it's actually important for you. Now, think of the worst case scenario if really it fails. In my case, starting YouTube, a worst case scenario would be that I made an inappropriate content that offended a lot of people. So yeah, my YouTube career is ruined, my personal life is ruined. So what can I do? So at least for now, my solution would be I'll send out a public apology to as much media as possible because, well, it's my mistake. I have to admit it. And then I will quit YouTube. Maybe I don't no longer deserve to be here, so I quit it. And yeah, proceed to be a normal person again, like being a 9-to-5 salary man or something. But of course, there'll still be criticism from people all around me, but at least I've done what I should be doing, like apologizing. So I believe that's the best thing I can do. And so now that I think of the worst case scenario, I think, can I accept that? Can I accept if I fail, I do this? I think it's okay because the reward is so important that even if the worst case happens, I found a solution and I'm okay with dealing with it that way. So yeah, now if you accept your solution, you shouldn't be afraid. And you shouldn't have any fear anymore. So just start it out. And actually, by this time, you might have this feeling of fear of regret, which is good, because you might be afraid that you will regret if you don't ever start this. You might regret that when you're old, you tell your grandchildren about how you regret not starting out this when you're younger. So yes, to prevent that regret, let's start it. And there's this quote from this book which I'm currently reading. It's called 4-Hour Workweek. It's a good book, by the way. So it talks about fortune favors the bold. Get started even if you don't have all the facts in hand. Don't be the one who refuses to change even though they have all the facts in hand. Get started today, guys. And yes, if you like this video, do give me a like and subscribe to my channel So feel free to check out Intot's channel, which I actually produce this podcast with Verene, my girlfriend, where we talk about incongruous thoughts ranging from our daily life to like philosophical stuff. So random ideas that we have. Or yeah, you can actually check out my YouTube channel, which see whatever video which I produced when I was younger. But yes, if you like this content, I'll be producing something like this in the future as well. And yes, thanks everyone for watching, and see you guys next time. Bye bye.